I am Noelle Sawyer, and I am at Southwestern University. It's a small liberal arts college just north of Austin, Texas. I remember being good at math often, but also my grandma during the summers, Ma, we called her, would just have us in school, basically. She was a teacher and then a principal. So like I also had to do math all summer, pro and con. And I had a couple of teachers that were really good, right? And so I enjoyed math. And also my parents gave me the space to do it, right? Like a lot of space and time to do my homework. So I don't know if I was good or just very supported. This is fun because I have never known that I wanted to be a mathematician. I just knew I didn't want to do lots of other things in college, right? Like I'd take a class and basically go, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this either. And I basically ended up with a math and history major, both of those in undergrad by process of elimination. And then I went to grad school because I found out that a PhD was paid, possibly, right, instead of a master's. So I said, I'll do that. And I was like, I like teaching. If I get a PhD, I can teach whatever I want. And then I weighed what I knew about the job market, which is I should do math and not history, probably, but I don't want to discourage anyone else. My research is focused in two main areas right now. So all of them do a mix of geometry, right? Like shapes and angles as we know them. Topology, which I think about as like a more general thought process of shape, right? Is it round, right? Questions like that. And dynamics, which studies how things move around. One of the areas I'm in is in thermodynamic formalism, which sounds scary, but I just tell people it's mathy physics. So I'm doing a lot of work to find out like, hey, does this system of motion have an equilibrium state? Like, do things just stay put, right, in the physics sense, but there's also a mathematical sense to think about this. So I am working on that with quite a few collaborators. There are five of us in total, so that's one area. But my thesis work and more work I'd like to do is in something called Mach-Planck spectrum rigidity, which really asks, if you know the general shape of something, the topology, and your friend only has information about like how long it takes to make loops on whatever object you're holding, you should be able to put this information together and give like the exact size and shape and any weird in pieces of information like divots or sharp points or things like that. So that area asks, when can we know that, right? Like, when is that enough information? And I do that specifically in negative curvature, which is when I just really want angles to be really small. Definitely racism, right? Like if we're just going to come out the gate and say something like that is probably number one. White people don't often think about the difficulty of like not being white in certain spaces. And so a lot of my issues are some of them like feel mundane, right? Like someone assumes I'm a little bit less smarter than I am. Sometimes someone assumes I'm a lot less smart than I am. I also have had weird, like, I don't like racist paternal things where like white men in math really want to like take me under their wing by force, right? Like they really want to help me. And if I decline, they will follow up, right? Because surely I didn't mean to decline their help, right? Because I don't know what's good for me. And that is hard, right? Like it's hard to navigate all of that. And that's just one of the issues I mentioned. And then I also have to do my job, right? Or I also have to do my quals, or I also have to do my oral defense. Like I have to do all of these things. And also someone is like waiting to bother me with nonsense. Number two is just the US immigration system, right? Like it's very costly to be here, right? And to keep coming here. It's less costly if I never want to travel outside of the country, but I like seeing my family, and I want to go to the Bahamas and see them, right? So I spend a lot of money and time on just not being a US citizen or resident. I and a collaborator got funding from AIM to run a semester-long program for Dynamics grad students, virtual because it's accessible, and also traveling's just hard, man. So we had a few people come and give talks on like what we called foundational papers in Dynamics. And then we sorted the students into reading groups and had them meet across about 12 weeks. And we just had like a wrap-up conversation with them at the end. But we also gave them basically like paper TAs, right? So we had mentors in the program who held office hours. So students who were reading the papers in their groups and got stuck could go to office hours and ask about the paper. And I am just happy because it's the kind of thing I want to do, right? Like I like community building in math. I want more friendly people in Dynamics, right? Like I want more people to thrive because I want some more friends. And I'm also really proud that I was in a place in my life this year that I got invited to be the faculty speaker at USTARS. For people who don't know, it's the Underrepresented Students in Topology and Algebra Research Symposium. And they only have one faculty speaker, and I was like really happy to be able to go and see underrepresented students in a room. I don't give a lot of talks about my personal journey anymore because trauma, right? But that is a place I was happy to share some of my math and some of my journey. So I think I am making space for myself in math in ways that aren't just research, and I'm really happy about that. The Vassar Math Department, right, while I was there, right, quite a few of the professors were very good to me, right? And then in grad school, like, I really loved my advisor, Dave Constantine. Like, I picked him because he did not, like, send me out of his office when I was like, I would like to do math, and also I have a feeling, right? You know, like, having a tough time in grad school early on, and he would talk to me about it before he was my, like, PhD advisor, right? So that was really good. He's at Wesleyan, and quite a few other people in the department. Like that was the correct department for me. I think I thrived as much as I could have in grad school, right? Like under the current setup we have of quals and all of the other things I don't quite like, but I think the people there were really good for me. And like my current, like my best friend, Frida, who is helpfully in this photo behind me, was my office mate in grad school. And we supported each other through some tough times, right? Like we're still supporting each other now. Candace Price, I feel like was definitely like a career altering moment for me when I actually met her once at like the women conference at Smith, because I wanted to be her, right? Like she's so cool and amazing. And like, she's got a, you know, a new job and she was doing so well. And she was at this conference and then she talked to me and she wanted to support me, right? Like, I love her, right? So she's definitely someone that really stands out to me as like one of the reasons I didn't quit math, right? Like I'm still here in academia. And there's quite a few other people. I guess we don't have time to name all of them, but I also love my department where I am, right? Like that's really helpful. Like the math and computer science department at Southwestern is amazing and kind. And like they covered my classes when I needed to fly out and get a visa last minute so I could actually travel. They're always asking me if I need stuff. My family was visiting, someone like gave me a car seat for my, you know, so I didn't have to find two for my nieces. When I moved here, someone gave me like a list of food, like food places they liked. And if they were ordering curbside, cause it was summer 2020, COVID, right? I lent me furniture when mine took so long to get here. I guess I don't I'm saying a lot of things that are like emotional support, right? Rather than mathematical support, but like that's what I needed, right? And that's what I needed. So I have been very lucky, right? To find a lot of people along the way who are helpful. And I didn't mention them specifically, but like my family being like family that I like and is supportive and is like incredible, right? So I love them. That's why I love for them to come and visit me at my apartment and like take up all the space in here and like get on each other's nerves for a week. Like I love it so much. So like things are hard, but I have really good people around me. What I just always tell people is if you decide you want to do something like go to grad school, and I think this is generally good life advice. I'm just saying this because it's the circumstances we're in. Like, just put in as much effort into building a community as you do going to school, right? As you do going to work, right? Like, however that happens for you and whatever that means. Maybe that means you are trying to move somewhere where you already have friends or family, right? But maybe that's hard. We know as academics, that's not a thing you can necessarily do in grad school or work. But like wherever you end up, right? Like work on finding friends. They don't have to be in grad school with you. They don't have to understand what you're doing, right? I think this is a huge mistake I think academics make, right? Like thinking that other academics are the only people who will ever understand them. But like, why would you want to be friends with copies of you at all times, right? Like, find some people to hang out with, right? Like, keep some hobbies if you can, a single hobby that you could hold on to. Find a group around town. Like, there's Facebook groups for the weirdest things, right? Like, you can also, like, find, like, there's people of color hiking meetups, right? If you like to hike and that's who you want to hike with, just have something that's not your job, right? Or the thing that you're studying, like have something that you love to do so that when you are sad about what you're doing and you're not sure if you want to do it anymore, or you're trying to figure out your life plans, a deciding factor is not going to be, this is all I have. And if you decide to stay knowing there's other stuff that could make you happy, I think it's just so much easier on your body, right? So much easier on your mind, right? To just be doing something because you want to do it, not because you have to do it, not because it's the only thing to give you some pleasure or like satisfaction in life.